I can just get up here and wing it. I'm just gonna, you know, say thank you very much for applauding my desire to not prepare for things. But today I just like wrote a few words right before I came to say, because emotions are very high. First of all, thank you for being the most incredible audience for any live performance I guess I've ever experienced. I honestly feel like, I think that there's literally like 5 people in the house tonight who have no idea what Be More Chill is, who just came to the show. These poor people are just like, I mean, it's pretty good, but did I miss something? So my sympathies to those 5 people. You're welcome. You're welcome, person. And just to give you a little context before I start this speech that I wrote on a notepad. Everyone is crying backstage. This is a mess. This is a real emotional. Everyone says, "Oh yeah." I mean, it's real. Everyone's very upset. And I was backstage waiting to come on. And you know, my wife Lauren is in the show, and so. And Amanda, who works on the show, saw Lauren hysterically crying in the corner, and she said to me, "You should go over there and comfort your wife." And I looked at her and I just went, "No." Like, I gotta worry about me right now. Okay, I'm gonna give my little speech. and if anybody wants to film anything that happens, I think it's okay. So don't feel like you have to covertly bootleg the show like you've been doing for 6 months. Just let it all hang out. What are you gonna do to us now? So listen, Be More Chill is a show that has defied odds every step of the way. Since it was born in New Jersey in 2015, this musical has been embraced, bullied, elevated, ignored, energized, and weirdly parodied. And it has survived and thrived. We were resurrected in a way that no musical has ever been resurrected. We got to New York City in a way that no musical has ever gotten to New York City, and then we got to Broadway in a way that no musical has ever gotten to Broadway. And yes, we are ending our Broadway run today, and that is a bummer. And I would like to just, so many people over the last few weeks, months, whatever, when they want to talk about the closing, they'll say like, "Oh, you know, it's closing, that's sad, but like, you know, you should be so proud of what you accomplished." And I am, I totally am, but also it's like a bummer that things close. And so can we just do one collective aww on three, just for the bummer aspect of the fact that the show is closing. Everyone please, 1, 2, 3.
Aww.
Thank you, we took care of it, we're satisfied. But listen, if we had to end, how cool that we're ending like this. How cool that we're ending with a performance that was so passionate and insane and excited, and we're ending with our costumed heads held high. Proud of this thing that we made that was born out of love and honesty and loyalty and scrappiness and sequins and joy. Now, every single person in this room is part of this. This is a musical that got to Broadway and beyond. Turning the page, hold. Because actual human beings discovered it. We got here because actual people fell in love with this weirdo musical and dug the show tunes and dug the characters. And then these people who loved the show weren't afraid to show everyone just how much they loved it. So to everyone here in this beautiful building on 45th Street, and to everyone out there watching, everyone out there in bedrooms and hospital rooms, and offices, and tiny little black box theaters, and gymnasiums, and libraries, and to the two strange teenagers who are currently getting stoned behind the bleachers, who feel like no one sees them or takes them seriously, I just want to say that we do. And we do. And we promise two stoned teenagers to keep making strange, heartfelt, uncynical art that celebrates the weirdos, the outcasts, the creeps, the loser geek whatevers who live in all of us. Thank you all for believing.